head down to the coin toss is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams out of the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Freeman's a guy that knows that he's going to have to carry his load today, as well as some of his teammates out there, because this is a tough spot. He's been there before, but not everybody has been.
I think patience will be the big word for him today. As a talented wide receiver, you're playing on the road. You want the ball in your hands. You want a chance to make a difference in this game. And if they start off a little bit slow, he's got to be patient and let the game come to him and be a tremendous leader and eventually allow this offense to execute and be able to win this game in a tough environment.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 44. Throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
And he's hit before he could go anywhere. Fires out to his receiver. Drop back a yard.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
Third and 11 here. Ball on the 43. Looks to him again. Complete. And down he goes at the 48-yard line. Well, they get all those yards, but come up just shy of the first.
Good play call. Almost perfect execution, except for the fact that they're not going to get the first down.
Out to around the 38, and they come up big on fourth down.
Gutsy call here on the option. He had a good help up front by the offensive line. He's able to bust through there for a heck of a game.
From the 38-yard line, first down. Steps out of bounds at the 38-yard line.
Let's see if this coaching staff sticks with the short passing game, or if they decide to open it up a bit more.
Great tackle at the 29. This is the eighth play of this drive. He's scrambling.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. Here's an opening. Tackle made at about the 13. 10th play of the drive. They get nice yardage on that run. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Here's the give. Good outside run there.
The offensive coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the fifth first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
Touchdown.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw there.
And he hits the PAT. So a 12-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 7-0.
McCarthy has it at the 5,
gets out to about the 21. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. He's going to try and scramble. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Dives forward. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
From their own 32-yard line, it's first down.
Ouch.
Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen. Maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
Throws it in a hurry. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line. The D sniffs out the screen pass and holds him to a short gain.
Contain, contain, contain. That's the only way you can shut down a guy with 4-2 speed.
Third down and 13. Ball on the 28. He lets it fly. Got it. They'll bring him down around the 29-yard line. First and 10 after the big pass play. Straight run here, and he's got nowhere to go.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play. I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
They'll line it up again on third down. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. Play of the series. The Bears saw one of their top players going down earlier, but it looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. On the ground with the tailback, and he's stopped behind the line, and the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Finds his receiver. Touchdown. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Nolan has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Second down and 9 to go.
Ball on the 26-yard line.
We've played one. We get a tie game at 7-7. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
Quick out to his receiver. He's to the 40. He gets hit out of bounds.
At about the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line, first down.
Big opening.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
He's at the 40. He's at the 30, to the 20. And he's taken down.
Right around the 10-yard line.
So they pick up big yards on the option keeper.
I thought he's going to break that one for a touchdown. You couldn't draw that up any better.
So first and goal after that huge run. And it pays off. Touchdown.
He tops 100 yards on the ground with that last run.
Sooner or later, they're going to have to start keying in on the run. When that happens, I'd look for him to start to try to do some more with the passing game.
And he tacks on the extra point. Felder is lined up to kick this one off. He gets out to about the 18-yard line.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
That play fake good for 5 yards.
That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
He's into the open field. He keeps it on the option and picks up maybe 4.
Second and 6 coming up here.
Ball on their own 37. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
A bad play overall by the offense to
quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Poole is back deep to return. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. He's tackled at the 23. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Now he tries to buy some time. Excellent open field tackle.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Now he's scrambling.
The offense caught him flat-footed to convert that third and long. You can tell by the coach's reaction that that is a huge disappointment.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. The stop at the 45. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
A little toss across the middle. Tackle around the 41-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That'll make it third and five.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. He's at the 20, the 10, and he's all the way in for the touchdown. And once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
This young man is no stranger to the end zone. That's two rushing scores for him on the day, and you have to love the way he's been running the ball all game.
The extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That makes it second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on their own 29 as they head to the locker rooms. This one is far from over. 21-7.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves the second half.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I tell you what, you got to give these guys credit. They put up a great defensive effort in the first half. They carry it over in the second half. Doesn't look like they're going to give in.
Yeah, and this game isn't over yet. I think it's going to require them to continue to play with this kind of edge and attitude to be able to give themselves a chance to win the game, because we still have a ball game in our hands and still a whole quarter to go.
He's tackled right around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, first down. Zips it to the tight end, and down he goes, right around the 40.
That makes it second and eight.
He scrambled. It's third down and 14 yards to go now after that setback by the sack. Tackle made at the 43-yard line. Nolan is waiting for the snap. And he's tackled at the 21.
You know what? It might not have been a lot, but they moved the ball forward. Football's not a game won 100 yards at a time. You take what you can get.
The offense is on its way out on the field again, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone in their past couple of drives. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31. He has some room. He makes his way to about the 45. First and 10, ball on the 45-yard line. Gets to about the 44-yard line. At the 30, makes it to the 24.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs is pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line.
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. He's taken down at about the 15-yard line.
Number 17 makes the tackle at the 15-yard line. That'll make it second and inches.
I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. Mike 8.
Got some open field. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal.
That's good for the game.
It's first down. First and goal here. Let's see if they keep it on the ground inside the five. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
And he converts the extra point. Felder has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll bring him down at the 38-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 38-yard line. One's incomplete.
Vincent was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Mike 8. Larry.
Moves up in the pocket, and down he goes.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
So the sack makes this third and very long. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he hits him hard at the 31-yard line. Looks like the defense was in man coverage there, fellas, and that's why they stopped that screen.
Yeah, and when the secondary isn't dropping back into zone, it makes it difficult to have success with that kind of screen play.
Poole back deep to return. And this one is a beauty. They'll bring him down at the 33-yard line. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
And now he's going to run. Dives, and he's down. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. He gets rid of this one. And he's tackled around the 47-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. He's at the 40. Brought down in the open field.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
Two times. Two times. Two
downs, two downs.
Setting up blockers, or running back's got it on the screen, and he shoved out of bounds
at about the 33-yard line.
That brings him second and five.
From the 33-yard line, it's second down. He's at the 20, and he's taken down
right around the 18-yard line.
We head to the fourth. 28-7. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Slings it. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. And this play is number 8 on the drive. He's scrambling. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. Touchdown. He didn't see anyone open, so he just took it in himself.
This quarterback is fearless, and the defense needs to either spy him or walk the safeties up when they've got the ball down near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. Felder gets set to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your effort. Believe me, coaches notice the ones who aren't trying that hard.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. And they make the stop around the 30-yard line.
That'll bring up third and inches.
Short game there by the tailback, and he's still going to come away with a first down.
Not a huge run, but enough to move the chains, and that's all that matters.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Scrambling around. Tackle around the 31-yard line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
They come out in a 5-wide set. Quick strike to the receiver. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
From their own 43-yard line, first down. Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way. Brought down at the 44-yard line.
They've just been outmatched and outplayed this entire game. That pass was thrown with very little confidence, and it was an easy interception for the defense.
He makes his way to about the 28. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Blue 19. Blue 19.
run up the middle.
Game seven on the play. That'll bring up second and three.
McBride will run it again. He gets out to about the 11-yard line. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
He's tackled at the 2-yard line. The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Goes at the 1-yard line. There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Tackle made just outside the goal line. Freeman's performance today, I think nationally, Kirk, it's going to take a hit as him being a superstar. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it could hurt him, but at the same time, the team won. He didn't have a great game, but the fact that his team was able to kind of rally and still come up with a win, I still think could help his cause as far as some of the national recognition.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.